What is going on, AD fam? I hope you all are having a good day. So as you know, Alexis and I just got two pretty much brand new bikes. The FE350, she got the KTM, and we are both very happy with our purchases. So in today's video, I'm gonna be showing you guys my first ride on my new bike. Technically, I lost the footage of the actual first ride.
You are fake news.
But I went right back out and did the same thing again, so I was able to cover a lot of the things and then add some more value after my first little ride. We're actually gonna be doing the same thing with Alexis once she hops on and goes on her first ride. But I'll just go ahead and say right now that I absolutely love the bike and I'm a very happy owner. So let's go ahead and flash back to a week ago and roll the clips. So he's got some kind of aftermarket bar pad on here. It's kind of obnoxious. I gotta take it off because I gotta move the handlebars. I'm gonna rotate them a little bit. And sure enough, he doesn't have the factory one. I actually think we're gonna run a steering stabilizer on this bike as well, so I'm pretty stoked for that. I'm gonna grab the factory Husky toolkit, rotate these forward a little bit, and I think I'll be happy with the stock bars.
Woo-wee! You match.
Woo! Let's go, baby! Woo! So this is gonna be my first ride on the FE350. Well, kinda. Lost some footage from the actual first ride, but first impression, first thoughts. Dude, this bike is amazing, man. I love this thing. The power that it delivers, the suspension. I miss this bike. So I've actually rode one of these, a 2020 model. My buddy MJ bought one brand new, brought it straight to my house, let me play around on it. And I did multiple rides on that bike, but it's a different feeling being your own. And all the bikes that I've ridden over the past few years, I've grown a lot as a rider and figuring out what I really need. And man, this thing just feels so nimble, so agile, and I love the way that it delivers power. But I didn't want to leave you without any riding footage in this video, so let's go hit some trails around here and give you my first thoughts. Woo! Nose heavy on that one. Oh my god. It is just, it feels so confidence inspiring. Like, this bike is meant to be ridden hard, and it just shows. Straight off of the 300L Dual Sport, you can't even compare the two bikes. Like, this is in a completely different league. The power is really difficult to describe. The only word that you can use is linear. Like, it's very smooth. It comes on smooth. Let's see if we can stall this thing. So I'm in second gear right now, and this is just me idling. I'm in first gear right now, just idling. Let's stab on the throttle and see if we can get it to stall. I wanted to, but it didn't. So right off the bat, way better experience than I had with the 450L. I mean, that's the last larger bore bike that I can really compare it to, is the 450L. And the reason why I didn't like that bike so much was all the flame out issues, the 450 choppiness. Oh, hey, buddy. The choppiness of the 450 and just the motocross roots of that bike. Like, this power is addicting, man. It's nice. It's the closest that you can get to that 300 two-stroke lugging feel. They nailed it with this bike. Don't forget to blast through this cattle guard. Like, just from riding it the little bit that I have, I feel like that I made the right decision. I am so happy on this bike. The ergonomics, the weight, the power, it makes you want to go find the gnarlier stuff. And we're not going to get too technical on this ride. I'm not exactly dressed for it. And there's not a lot of seriously gnarly stuff around here. It's mostly just Jeep trails and some two track. So I'm in third gear right now. How fast are we going? Like 20 miles an hour. And this thing feels pretty happy. Like, this thing is gonna be amazing in the flow sections. But after rotating the bars forward, I don't even think I'm gonna have to get a different bar setup or a riser. But yeah, man, this thing feels great. Even standing up, the stock bars seem to do just fine for me. I don't know how many positions there are in the bars, but there's another set of holes, so I can even move them forward a little bit more, which I probably will. But yeah, I don't think I'm gonna need any risers or anything. The stabilizer that I plan on getting is one that a lot of the factory riders use, so it doesn't add any height. I was gonna go with the Scotts so I could run a little bit of a riser, but honestly, this feels good and I don't want to mess with the ergonomics too much. My KTM, I was running the stock bars when I had it and I got used to it, so do a little pivot turn. Oh, we just spinning. The old AT950s, man, we gotta get some different tires on here ASAP. That's another thing, I don't know what tires I'm gonna run. These things will get burned up so fast on the road. I don't know whether I want to go with a more dual sport tire or more of a cheater tire. The gummy tires just get chewed up so fast. And especially, I still want the aspect to be able to hop on the road. I don't know what I should do, man. If you have any good tire recommendations, drop it in the comments down below. I'm in kind of a hard spot. Like, I don't plan on doing a lot of dual sport stuff, but some of the softer tires get chewed up so fast on the road. So I'd like to still have that option and not cringe every time that I see pavement. There's just levels to bikes. And like I said, man, this is the mountain bike compared to the Harley that I was riding that is the 300L. And I wanna have the option to ride fast, ride hard, continue to grow. And I'm gonna try to shut up about the 300L, just trying to explain myself on why I made the decision and everybody commenting, dude, you can do that on that bike and blah, 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 blah. Like, you should have just done this and that and that, and you're a shitty rider. And just like, dude, I am so happy with this decision. So that's all that really matters to me. I know that I made the right decision, man. This bike is awesome. Oh crap, this is kind of getting gnarly through here. Not bad for some Jeep trails. Just super rocky. Oh man, the rock garden here. These are sharp too. I'm honestly surprised at how well this thing handles the low speed. Like, coming from the 250 XCW and how easy those bikes are to ride slow and the luggability, and they're really hard to stall. This gives me a similar sensation. You know, it's not as good, but it's close, and that's what I was going for. If I could have the 300 two-stroke, I would, but I still want something that I can hop on the road and not have to worry about burning up a top end, do some connecting trails on the highway, and not sweat it. This was the perfect compromise. Like, I'll have to ride a newer 500 soon, and that'll really solidify my purchase decision, whether I regret not getting the 500. But for only being able to have one bike and spending most of the time off-road, dude, I'm so happy with this bike and the power that it makes. I think the only time that I would miss the extra power is on the road. Woo! But I definitely can't see myself asking for more power on the trails. I will say though, in first, it is definitely still jumpy. Like, it's kind of got that on or off feeling. Like, you just got to get used to easing into it. Just bump it up in a second. Yeah, this bike is money. They nailed it. I've always heard great things about the 350, and people who have owned them have been very happy with them. But I honestly just don't remember being this happy with this bike back when I rode it the first time. And like I said, I was still kind of in that limbo of the dual sport and like ending up with the 450L and not liking that bike. And my buddy ended up lowering his too and adjusted the suspension for his weight. So when I got to ride it again, it just didn't feel right to me. But after buying one, now owning it, in this first little ride, oh my gosh, I can't even describe how happy I am with this machine. I'm curious to see at high speeds how the suspension will handle it. I am on the heavier side still for the factory suspension. I will probably mess with the clickers and see if I can get it close enough. But maybe someday I will get the suspension done and properly valved for my weight and riding style. You know, that's the best mod that you can do. And I can hear the keyboard warriors already. Why are you willing to dump the money into this bike, but you wouldn't into the 300L? Well, at the end of the day, guys, the 300L is still the 300L. Like, you still have all the excess weight. You still have the same engine. Like, you still have all of the other downfalls. You know, you fix the suspension, cool, that's one thing. Yes, it would completely transform the bike.
But at the end of the day, it's still gonna be nowhere as good as something like this off-road. Overall though, I am loving the suspension. It is super plush, but firm enough to where you do get those hard hits. It's not throwing you all over the place. This thing is tracked straight. It loves all of those aggressive rock gardens and everything that I just took it through. I know this isn't like a super serious riding review or anything, so this is just my first initial thoughts, and I can't say it enough, man. I really do enjoy this bike. But yeah, I'm probably just gonna rip around for a little bit with the camera off and just take everything in, and man, I'm really happy. So if you have ridden one of these bikes or you're curious about it, drop your comments down below. I'm sure somebody else with more experience can answer a lot of these things. But over the next few months in this riding season, I can't wait to really ride the hell out of this bike and further grow my opinion and thoughts and feelings on this machine. But I am as happy as a kid on Christmas right now. This is all, oh buddy. I think we found some single track. No way. This is either single track or a horse trail or both. Or neither. Yeah, it's definitely neither. If you are curious about what pants that I'm riding in, these are the new Climb Invisible XL. These things offer superior protection and durability and breathability. And these are the new Garnier SG13s. They did a collaboration with Nike. Don't be me. I know. I'm dumb. What gear am I in? Is this second? Oh yeah, that was second, and that was perfect. I gotta get better at utilizing the engine braking. With a two-stroke, you don't have any. So most of the time, I find myself pulling in the clutch when I'm going down hills, even on this bike. And it can honestly be kind of nice on these steeper downhill sections to just let the bike do its thing. Use the RPMs to slow you down, save the brakes. Ah.
Oh, buddy.
God, that's so satisfying, not having to clap out my wrists, bottom out my suspension on a little jump like that. That's a nice feeling.
Well,
love it.
Yay.
Extremely happy with it.
Good.
Ride's amazing, buttery smooth. Suspension's great, power's great. Super easy to ride. Like coming from the 300L, this thing just wants to go. Gnarly stuff is just like, come on, we upgraded. Woo-hoo!
Well, that wraps up my first ride and review. As you could hear in my voice, man, I love this bike. So much fun to ride. No real complaints so far, and I've already done a pretty gnarly single track video, so stay tuned for that. But yeah, over the past couple weeks, I've really got to develop my opinion, and overall, everything is looking good, and these bikes are gonna stay around for a while. So we've got a list of parts that we're about to order, get these things fully built, ready for mountain bashing. But if there's anything in particular you would like to see or any questions that you have for me, drop it down in the comment section below. That's gonna do it for today's video. So if you enjoyed, please hit that like button, subscribe if you're new, turn the notifications on, all that good stuff. And until the next video, live free and adventure daily.